My oven shines so bright, you would think it was highlight.
Hashtag Bruja and its associated hashtags have over 1 million posts on Instagram. But what does it mean? And why are so many people, particularly women of color, posting about it?
We're realizing that conventional allopathic ways of healing are not helping us.
We have the Bruja movement, right? Hashtag Brujas of Instagram, that has completely transformed women.
You can make a difference in this world, and you need to be reminded of that, because this world is constantly trying to make you think that you can't, but you can.
Bruja and brujería translate into English as witch and witchcraft, respectively. But if you're thinking of black pointy hats and Halloween masks, that's not what we're talking about here.
We're talking about a particular kind of witchcraft with roots across African, European, Latin American, and indigenous cultures. It can mean many things for different people, but features of brujería can include anything from believing in astrology, burning candles, to connecting with the spiritual realm, crystals and spells. Here in Brooklyn, this magic is distinctly Afro-Latina, and I've come to talk to one of the biggest Instagram Bruja influencers to see why she thinks so many women are engaging with hashtag Bruja.
A lot of people have been finding that, you know, religion can be very restrictive in ways and that spirituality can be a lot more expansive. I'm Emilia Ortiz. I'm a Bruja spiritual advisor and healer from Brooklyn, New York. I'm a Brooklyn native. I am both a self-practitioner and practitioner within the community. There's this aspect of reconnecting with your ancestors and also about there being more than just going to God for answers and this piece of like, okay, I can ask for all these things and then not do anything. I don't have to make offerings. Yes, you do, because no spirits are gonna work for you if you ain't giving them like, do you wanna work for free? That don't make sense. And I think a lot of people resonated with that because at this day and age, so many of us, first of all, we all want to be paid for what we do. And I think people resonate a lot with the fact that like, okay, why is God going to just want to do these things for me first of all? Or why is God just punishing me? Or just not feeling like they were getting enough answers.
What Amelia is saying about people turning to spirituality over institutional religions lines up with what research is telling us about changing religious belief in the United States.
We know that the number of people in the US who identify as spiritual but not religious is growing, but there's another interesting statistic here. A Pew study has found that the rate of belief in New Age ideas, now that can include anything from astrology to ancestor worship, is particularly high in two groups. Historically, Black Christian denominations and Catholics, the numbers are higher than what we would see in traditionally evangelical, Protestant, mainline denominations.
Afro-Latina women fit into these communities that Pew Research Center is saying are turning to what it calls New Age practices. But there's nothing new about brujería. Latin and Central America are full of syncretic faiths. That means the fusion of two or more religions, where Catholicism has met with African and indigenous religions. In Brazil, you've got candomblé. In Cuba, Santeria, and voodoo in Haiti. The region's history of European colonization and the transatlantic slave trade has created a smorgasbord of spiritual beliefs here, many of which have celebrated brujería. But the Catholic Church has traditionally denounced witchcraft. For many, brujería has been an underground practice or simply forbidden. Posting on Instagram about it is breaking taboo.
And that word throughout the world, especially since, you know, the advent of European colonialism, has been used to demonize powerful women. And so much so that most people might know about the witch trials, specifically here in Massachusetts, in the US, but that has a legacy of hundreds of years with European women and then African women. And we chose to bring that word back because there's so much power in it. My name is Griselda Rodriguez Solomon, and along with my twin Miguelina, we are the Brujas of Brooklyn. In creating the Brujas of Brooklyn Instagram account, it was almost like we came out I'm gonna be honest. Till this day, my mother is still not 100% comfortable with us using this identity. The witch throughout history has been a very powerful woman connected to a higher power, using elements to heal, like plants and fire and intuition. Unfortunately, because of patriarchy, that type of woman is a bit too powerful. So that's been an identity that has been repressed.
That power Griselda is referring to for many is met with skepticism. And that's not just from a Catholic church that for centuries has seen these practices as heretical. Historically and today, there's been concern that people are choosing brujería over official health routes.
In the 20th century, in the 1940s and 50s in Puerto Rico, brujería became not so much a heresy, but a problem of public health. And during campaigns for modernization and rationalization on the island, government bodies waged anti-superstition campaigns and marked folk healers and curanderas and brujas as anti-modern. They needed to get on board with Western medicine. Even later in the 1970s and 1980s, psychiatrists, psychologists, and different doctors were really interested in Puerto Rican healings as impediments to people seeking real medicine or real solutions. And I think some of these questions are misguided. I think that there is not a world in which people are only seeking out the guidance of brujas and not going to doctors. They offer answers to questions that cannot be answered by medicine. Problems of romance, problems of partners gone astray, that it gives people a profound sense of control.
In pursuit of that sense of control, the growth of hashtag Bruja seems like lots of things, a reclaiming of heritage, spirituality, as well as part of the modern appetite for wellness and a need for a digital safe space to explore all of this. But the online community is now so large here in Brooklyn that people are actively gathering and celebrating in real life too.
You need the salsa, follow it. There'll be a party on the other side of that door. So right now we are at my home space called House of Bread. But when we're not throwing Bruja Day raves, we host a lot of workshops, meditations, sound baths. We have a doctor who comes in who's a therapist, and he does open conversations about mental health and destigmatizing mental health in POC communities.
How many people in that room right now did you meet via Instagram?
95% of people in this party I've met via Instagram, definitely. There are a few like family, friends, but for the most part, it's people that I've connected with over the years on social media. I know Chiquita Bonita from Instagram, and now we're
IRL. Chiquita Brujita is a bruja that sells her candles here at House of Bread. But she's also a performance artist and runs her own festival dedicated to brujería in Brooklyn. She calls it an act of resistance.
When I think about what makes life worth living, I think about all of the moments that I am with others, right? That provides me with access to a well of energetic capital that I can then use in the moments where I encounter microaggressions, when I encounter explicit macroaggressions, right? When I encounter structural systems, policies, laws, patriarchy. I love having followers. I mean, having followers is just a crazy blessing, you know. I think that is amazing, of people supporting you and energetically cheering you on in these beautiful moments. And I think that that is really the, you know, the beauty of social and having so many people come out for the in real life things that I also offer, right? Which to me is the real power of this.
Do you feel like there are unsafe spaces for you as a bruja?
I think there's unsafe spaces for me as a person of color and a woman in 2020 alive in America. And I think that's a fact. I don't think it has anything to do with me being a bruja. I'm sure it does, but you know, I think that, you know, if anything, you know, I'm protected because of, you know, how I live my life It allows me to know that I'm moving in purpose and in service and with my heart in the right place.
Building a sense of community, whether it's in the church you grew up in or the culture and the spirituality that you fight to keep alive in diaspora, is no longer limited to the physical world. Somewhere in between the physical space, the spiritual realm, whatever it is you believe in, lies a new world of digital community. And it's so much more than just a hashtag.